Alright, here I am. Maintaining my balance again. Keeping my eyes on Mother Nature around me. My peripheral vision. My attention. Alright, this is what I'm starting to notice. The more attention we give to Mother Nature, or let's rephrase that, we can give Mother Nature our full attention, and our thoughts are arrive automatically. I just heard a bird tweet. I have the back door cracked. I slept with the back door open all winter. And the reason why I have it open just enough for the cats to go in and out is because I'm developing my thoughts and securities, confirmations on the possum that I had visit in the house. I had a possum come in the house. Alright, I noticed right there that I was looking to solve the riddle of a thought, and then a bird chirped and brought me right back to nature. Alright. Now I'm teaching at the speed of nature. Speed of nature. We can only speak when Mother Nature is quiet. Verbally. On these manufactured devices we have. Now I was getting lost in thought a little bit. I caught myself. I brought myself back to the attention. Ah, attention. That's why the military says attention. Wow. That's it. There's the natural root pattern. The military learned how to stand at attention with Mother Nature because Mother Nature was destroying their food source. In other words, out in India, the snow leopard is king of the mountain. And the snow leopard ate the goats and the sheep. Which were the primary source of the people to survive. The goats and the sheep provided milk that sustained as protein source for the people of the Himalayan mountains. I also saw that the snow leopard, being king at the top of the chain of the command of flesh-eating animals, that snow leopard is a descendant of the Tyrannosaurus Rex, who was the king of the flesh-eating animals during the prehistoric animal period. So you can see at one time Mother Earth was dominated by the animals. See that? See how that works? Because during the caveman period, mankind was in terror of his life. Just as today, it's the other way around. The animals are in terror of their lives under the dominating king of all flesh-eating animals on the earth, called the human being, in this age that we live in. Yeah, I had a good visit with Mother. And we watched a third movie in the series of India on Netflix. All of this information that I'm telling you is all played out from Hollywood. ever since Hollywood's conception. Way back many years ago. Because the information that I'm sharing with you is the ancient knowledge of the past. And at its root, that information, ancient knowledge of the past, was be at attention on the earth that we live on. Be quick to listen. Yep, just like I had some sounds from the roof of my house. I'm keyed into it like an animal, like a snow leopard is keyed into camouflage on the side of a mountain where the mountain goats roam. I must have been a mountain goat at one time. Yeah, I was. No wonder I'm a Capricorn. All Capricorns return mountain goats. And that includes zeroing in on sounds of coming from the front porch while you maintain your position as lien claimant in your city. Because I'm showing you, giving you the pathway to do it live right here on the internet, on YouTube. I don't just have a claim of lien. I have a foothold in the land. It goes all the way to Washington, D.C. And that's how we claim back our cities. All it takes is that one person to do it. Now I understand why my lien was significant. Yeah. Now I understand why my lien was significant. Yeah. So, I was a mountain goat. The movies that we just watched, Mother and I, yesterday. Now this brings me back to chakra root pain. Chakra root pain has to do with being anxious. Now, when the when the snow leopard camouflaged itself on the side of the mountain. It stayed still for long periods of time. And I can just imagine that the snow leopard that blended in to the colors of the side of the mountain could walk around undetected until the cat arrived upon its prey, which was its food source. That's why attorneys, they pray a prayer to the court judge. If you read your court papers or other people's court papers down in the public record, you can choose anybody's name and pull it up and look at it because it's public record. Any name, all names are the same. Now, this public record was also revealed in this India movie. And my mom's the one that's heavy into this knowledge, which is our history, where we came from. She has found all the history in the movies ever since Hollywood was created. Not all of them, but many of them that describe our struggle for balance with the animals. Because remember, at one time the Tyrannosaurus Rex ruled the earth, and the animals were in absolute control of mankind. And this represents the animal brain. The rule of the Tyrannosaurus Rex, who represented the animals, which gave the animals rule as kings on the earth. Because man used to be an animal. And the brains of mankind during the animal age was the size of the lower brain. In the back of the head, called the cerebellum. Man used to have small heads. when man extended his thoughts into the universe to desire to rule over the animals. Once the little cavemen started thinking in that direction, that's when the upper brain started to grow on top of the lower brain. Much bigger. Because the Tyrannosaurus Rexes, who ruled over the flesh-eating animals, were much bigger than the people, the tiny cavemen. You can just imagine the size of these Tyrannosaurus Rexes, because we have fossil bones, how big they used to be. One thing that you'll notice about bones is that they last long, 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 long time. Now you can see I could have took that description into the negative. And I could have said they don't rot easily. See how I did that? Took that thought into the negative. It was a description. Therefore, all descriptions have a male and a female side to them. And we learned this from the Illuminati ancient knowledge written in books, passed down orally also. Junior just walked into the room. He's an extension of Mother Nature. He's a cat. And he was... Judah was a panda cat. A panda is a cross between a cat and a bear. Hi, June. Now, I learned that predator and its food have a reciprocal relationship, where they take turns being reincarnated. So Junior used to be a panda. A panda would be hunted by a cat. small pandas. In the wild, we are used to seeing pandas colored black and white over here in North America. But over in India, they are colored light brown, and they are smaller. They are about twice or three times the size of a normal cat. As you can see, that would be significantly less than the size of your average bear. Yeah. Giving attention to Mother Nature is the source of our life. This is how we live, begin to live in the state of eternity. Boob just moved at about quarter speed across the floor. She stopped at the entrance to the door of the room, turned around, sat. Sat facing away from me, but turned around and started licking her back while she sat on the ground. See, right now, I am living with the cats. I am seeing what they are seeing because I'm watching their eyes and their ears. Their ears turn, make a sound. But they keep their attention focused on Mother Nature at all times. They're zeroed in to zero ground. Junior's got his attention on Boobs, who's in the other room now, making some noises, crawling on some bags. And Tiny's just sitting here, resting, looking away from me. She just moved her ears toward me when I did that. but she's still fixed in her own world. As she responded to the distraction, or to the natural sounds of nature. I made a sound. And you notice that the cat does not make any noise. He sits quietly all day. And the only time he makes noise is if he's yawning. Or if he's in the attack mode. Or if he's choking on a hairball. Cats were given the capacity to groom themselves. Thus, they eat a lot of hair. Seems that hair cannot be digested in the stomachs of the cats. The cow has many stomachs, about four different stomachs, each one more powerful than the other. That would be four different levels of acid. The body has its own natural incinerator. I just had a revelation, Veda, of collections. Food collecting in the stomach is an overcollection, and there is not proper incineration. The stomach, the incinerator, gets jam-packed full of food. Then the stomach suffers. That was the negative side of the description of the stomachs. Junior's listening to me talk, as well as sounds of someone hammering. And I'm tuned in to him as he's tuned into that. Now he just tuned into me, tuning into him. Now he's gonna come over here. See, I just predicted my cat's movement. That made him happy. Made him happy that I tuned in to him. And now he's coming over to get groomed and massaged to reestablish bonds. He was getting a drink of milk off the boob of life. He said, I need some yummy milks. Me some nourishment from the tree of life. Nourishments from the tree of life. Nourishments from the tree of life. Hey, nourishments. So the cat and the goat trade reincarnation positions. A cat gets reincarnated as a goat, and then a goat goes back into a cat.